I'm Dr. Vivek Subbiah from the University of Texas, MD Anderson Cancer Center, Houston, Texas. We're talking about testing for enteric fusions. They are rare in common tumors like lung cancer or breast cancer, and common in rare tumors like the MASC, which is the mammary analog secretory carcinoma or secretory breast cancer. And in pediatric patients, it is common in the rare tumors like congenital mesoblastic nephroma, infantile fibrosarcoma, and secretory breast cancer. There are four different methodologies that we can detect enteric gene fusions. FISH, which is the fluorescent in situ hybridization, RT-PCR, which is a reverse transcriptase polymerase chain reaction, immunohistochemistry, which is IHC, and next generation sequencing, or NGS panel. So let's talk about the difference between the DNA-based next-generation sequencing and RNA-based next-generation sequencing. With DNA-based NGS, there is potential for detection of multiple different targets. It detects fusions that may or may not be expressed. It requires tiling through intronic regions, which is difficult in genes with large introns, example, the enteric 3. The fusion positions here are inferred based on reads through genomic DNA. Let's talk about RNA-based NGS. There is potential for detection of multiple different fusions and splice size variants. There is detection of expressed transcripts. It reads directly through expressed transcripts, so no issues with introns, just as we have with DNA-based NGS. The fusion positions with RNA-based NGS are directly detected. This is a 46-year-old man who was diagnosed with stage 4 non-small cell lung cancer. After diagnosis, the patient received first-line platinum-based chemotherapy, unfortunately progressed after 9 months of therapy, and then was a PD-1 inhibitor, in this case, the immune checkpoint therapy with dostarlimab, unfortunately progressed after 2 months of therapy. At this time, a comprehensive next-generation sequencing panel was done, which revealed a TPM3 ENTREC1 gene fusion. Based on the fact that this patient's lung cancer harbored the ENTREC1 fusion, the patient was enrolled on an ENTREC inhibitor trial, in this case, larotrectinib. Partial response was achieved after 1.8 months. Disease was controlled for 39 months. Unfortunately, the treatment was discontinued due to progressive disease after 39 months. The detection of ENTREC1 fusion by comprehensive NGS testing conferred the gift of time to this patient. Let's talk about the key takeaways. Testing for ENTREC gene fusions in solid tumors is important. Testing options include immunohistochemistry, FISH, and RT-PCR. IHC is easily accessible, but lacks sensitivity and specificity for routine clinical use. FISH is highly sensitive, but requires technical expertise. The RT-PCR is able to identify fusion partners, but unfortunately cannot detect unknown fusion partners, and poor preservation of tumor samples reduces sensitivity to RT-PCR. Next-generation sequencing allows testing for multiple alterations simultaneously. RNA-based NGS is preferred for fusion detection, can detect additional gene fusions relative to DNA-based NGS. DNA NGS is, of course, an option, but some ENTREC1 and ENTREC3 fusions may not be detected. Thank you.